in the article which you have published in Communio, the International Catholic Review, you talk about this cheese making and relate it to the Benedictine way of life. In particular, I wonder if you could comment perhaps on another principle of Benedictine way of life, whereas some Catholic religious orders are missionaries and they go places, mm-hmm. and they move around. Benedictines take a vow of stability. And you talk about this principle of terroir, which is in the cheese world, the relationship between a food and where it comes from. So mm-hmm. can you relate as an example for us? You know, it's not just a question of food tastes better because it comes from this place, but what's the spiritual component of stability and terroir, mm-hmm. and how is that related to cheese?
Well, you know, the Benedictines, and remember we're talking with Cistercian also and Trappist, are the only ones who have a vow of stability. That's one of the vows that we take at final vows. So obedience, which is true, I think, for almost all religious orders. But then we have stability and conversatio. Now, stability means that I am vowing myself to God through this community, through this place, but it's really, you are identified with the spirit of a community. And so actually, I have a beautiful quote, which I'm going to try to find from Thomas Merton, which I love. Because he says, when the monks had found their homes, they not only settled there for better or for worse, but they sank their roots into the ground and fell in love with their wood. Indeed, this love of one's monastery and its surroundings is something integral to the Cistercian life. It forms the object of a special vow, stability. And they say you can recognize a person where they're from by the way they talk, by certain mannerisms, by the way they dress, even though they have the same habit. Because of this, you're taking on the character of a community. And it's really a marriage, you know, when you're vowed to religious life, that's your marriage. So, but the other vow that is really in complement to that is conversatio, which is also unique to us. So conversatio, it has to do with changing your whole way of life and obviously conversion. And it has an aspect of turning around. And it really is a good balance to stability because as great as stability is, you could become stagnant in staying one way. Whereas conversatio is saying, I am willing to change every day. And that's something we need, you know, you need in a marriage, you know, to say, okay, we're going to work this out and I'm willing to change. So I think those two vows are an amazing complement to one another.
Wow. Well, another, you know, when you mentioned that conversatio, that vow of conversion, as you put it, another book I've actually been teaching recently is Joseph Cardinal Ratzinger's book, Spirit of the Liturgy. And there's a really interesting chapter on liturgy, history, and cosmos, where he actually says the essence of Christian mystery isn't conversatio in the sense of just rejecting sin, which of course is important, but turning our awareness to God, turning back, right? So when you say conversatio, it's not just kind of always overcoming our negative tendencies, but a positive affirmation of a searching for God. Pope Benedict also had a beautiful essay on the Benedictine way called Carere Deum, seeking God. Mm. So the conversatio is seeing that creation began that there is an act of creation and that creation has an endpoint. It goes back to its creator.